we just really have a passion to share kind of our journey. And you know, immodesty is such a popular thing these days. You know, you go into a store and it's like the shirts and everything are just getting smaller and smaller. And I know we're not shrinking, and so I really don't know what's going on with the clothes. We've listened to girls going, but Mom, there's nothing else out there. There's nothing else for me to wear. This is it. This is all we're being given. So us girls were like, all right, we've got to do something about this. So we do a lot of layering. You know, as you can see, we take the modern styles and try to layer it over t-shirt and jeans. Girls don't realize what guys have to go through when you walk by and what you're wearing is affecting what they're thinking. And girls, we want to ignore it, you know, because we want to, you know, we want to be like, no, I don't have that kind of power, but it's true.
Another area in purity that we have taken a stand on is we have made the commandment not to date. And we believe that God has created our hearts to be whole and to be pure and not to be broken. We studied and asked God, what do you have? And he said, girls, it's not what I have for you. It's not something that I want you to do. I have called you to be pure and to not give your heart away to a bunch of different guys, because I know who I created you to be with, and I know what you need, and he created that. And we believe that there is one specific person out there for each of us, and God knows who it is, and in his time that he'll bring us together. We don't go alone with guys. We stay in groups, so it's safe. And we're just waiting and just not being distracted by that.
When we were 16, Mom and Dad sat us down and they took us out to a special restaurant. They asked us if we would consider not dating and not giving our hearts away before marriage. And once we said yes, it was our choice. I mean, through lots of prayer, Mom and Dad weren't forcing this down our throat.
Right.
Thank goodness. Through a lot of prayer, everything, they presented us this ring. And it's actually a bridal set. And mom actually picked out our diamonds, yeah. So they're actual real diamonds. And just to symbolize, the diamonds symbolize like the pressures of life. This purity is worth waiting for, and it's a valuable thing.
We wear it on our wedding ring finger to symbolize that we are already taken. We were like, are you married? Like, and it's a great conversation starter. We're like, no, in a way we're taken, but we're not married. So it's cool. God is amazing because he is a God of forgiveness and of second chances and of taking you where you are and getting you where he wants you to be if you are willing and you're willing to be obedient to him. Just surrender what has happened and surrender what you're going through and just throw it all aside and just say, God, I'm here, I'm desperate, and I need you so bad. And just give it to him because it's so worth it. I mean, it's so much better than carrying around all that junk with you. Is just let it go and let God carry it for you and let him be the God that he needs to be in your life and let him forgive you and let him just lead you where you need to be.
God's been teaching all three of us he's not looking for perfect people. He's not looking for great people. He is looking for people who are willing to be broken and to say, I don't have my life together. I'm desperate for something. And then you become desperate for God. And that is the best place for a human to be in. Don't try to be perfect. Don't try to fix yourself. Be desperate for God. And that's the greatest place for you to be.